I want to use this opportunity once again to thank President Trump for walking away from the terrible deal with Iran. The nuclear deal did not block Iran's path to the bomb. It paved Iran's path to an entire nuclear arsenal. And by removing the sanctions, it enabled Iran to bring in billions and billions of dollars to its coffers, which only fueled Iran's war machine in Syria, in Lebanon, in Yemen, and elsewhere. I believe that the president's decision to leave the disastrous Iran's deal was nothing less than a hinge of history. And Israel applauds the Trump administration's determination to reimpose tough sanctions on Iran and those doing business with Iran. I know that that view is shared by all our Arab neighbors, or practically everyone in this region, and I frankly believe that all countries who care about peace and security in the Middle East should follow America's lead and ratchet up the pressure on Iran. Because the greater the pressure on Iran, the greater the chance that the regime will roll back its aggression, and everybody should join this effort.
Right on spot target. It's a question of the highest importance for the United States that Iran never get a deliverable nuclear weapons capability. It's why President Trump withdrew from the wretched Iran nuclear deal. It's why he is reimposing economic sanctions. It's why we've worked with our friends in Europe to convince them of the need to take stronger steps against the Iranian nuclear weapons and ballistic missile program. It's why we continue to worry about Iran's role as the central banker of international terrorism. It's why we worry about Iran's belligerent military activity in Iraq, in Syria, with Hezbollah in Lebanon, and in Yemen. All of these threats in the region are also global threats because of the risk of international terrorism, and especially terrorist possible use of weapons of mass destruction.